Welcome to Sunday Yoga. I figured I wouldn't be in the best shape today, so I'm doing a little video now for you guys. Okay, so we're gonna start yoga on the floor. Sitting up nice and tall. Let your shoulders slide down your back. Reach the top of your head tall. Take a deep inhale in. And a heavy exhale out. Another deep breath in. And exhale. Lift your right arm up. Turn your fingertips down towards the floor. Take the left hand, and we're just going to stretch your forearm, starting to pull it back. Keep reaching for your wrist as you take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Tucking the fingertips, arm stays long. Release the stretch. Allow your hands to float back down towards your knees. I'm going to switch to the other side. Left arm extends, fingertips down. Grab with the right hand and gently pull that left hand back. Keep extending through the left knee or left wrist as you take a deep breath in. And let your breath go. Good, again. Deep breath in. And a deep breath out. Release the stretch. Allow the hands to float back down. Take another big stretch. Extend the arms up above your head. Exhale, palms onto your heart center. Extend the hands forward. Deep breath in. Exhale, open. Turn the palms out. Fingertips back. Extend through the palms. Feel that through your biceps, through the hands. Exhale, sweep the arms in and give yourself a hug. Tuck your chin. Inhale, arms reach forward. Fingertips back. Exhale, scoop the arms around, hug. Nice, again, inhale. Open the heart. Exhale. Last one, inhale, exhale, extend the arms all the way over your head, exhale, reach the hands forward, fold all the way down to the floor, relax your head, hanging heavy, slowly start to come back up to your seated position. And we move into seated cat-cow. Lift the heart up, shoulders roll back, drive the elbows down. Exhale, tuck the chin round the spine. Tuck the hips as you lean back, arms stay straight. Inhale, pull yourself forward, shoulder blades down, lift the chest. Exhale, tuck the chin, curl. Good, inhale, bring it forward, waking up the spine. You can do this outside. It's a great way to just keep the body warm. Or you can just stick with your air conditioning too. Inhale up to a neutral spine. Lengthening up through the crown of the head. Inhale, the arms extend all the way up. Big reach up. Exhale, elbows open out to the side. Open those arms out to angel arms. Elbows reach back, open at heart and hold. Take a deep breath in, abs stay tight. Moving those shoulders back. Exhale, soften the face, and take another deep breath in. Exhale. Breath in, arms extend back up. Exhale, arms extend back down. Going into our twist, we're going to extend the arms back up. We're going to take the right hand to our left knee, left hand behind, and go ahead, gently look over your left shoulder. Keeping the chest lifted. Deep breath in, exhale, twist deeper into the position, keeping the hips forward, body begins to rotate. Go ahead and extend, twisting to the opposite side. Exhale, hug, give yourself a gentle hug. Extend the arms up, eagle arms, so arms are already crossed, reach up. Grabbing the opposite hands here as you twist. Take a deep breath in, exhale, hug the elbows in. Deep breath in, arms extend up. Round through the core, extend through the shoulders. Exhale, hug back in, and another deep breath in as you pull up. Gently release, arms extend up, we switch the other side. Exhale, left hand to the right knee, right hand behind. Sit up tall, deep breath in. Exhale, twist to that upper body. Come back to the center, twist to the opposite side. Nice gentle twist. Giving yourself a hug, arms should cross the opposite direction. And as we come up, we grab a hold, left hand to that left shoulder. Deep breath in, exhale, hug the elbows down. Start to curl in towards your belly button. Inhale, arms extend up. Exhale and release. Coming into tabletop, take the hands in front, rolling over those feet. Hands should stack underneath the shoulders. Knees should be right underneath the hips. Start to move those hips to the right. Move the hips to the left. So just trying to create a little bit of movement. As you guys shift from side to side. Start to create this C shape by when your hips go to the right, your shoulders go to the right. So you're almost crunching into the side, but you're extending to the opposite side. Deep breath in, feel that rib cage stretch. Exhale, kind of back to center. Breath in brings us over to the other side. Push through those hands. Exhale, back to center one more time. Exhale, last time to the other side. Coming back to the center. Shifting those hips to the left, reaching the chest to the left. Exhale, release. Extend the arms all the way out for puppy dog. Hips stay lifted, arms extend out, relax the forehead down to the floor. And back to the front, bring your hands underneath you. Keep the left knee on the floor, pivot the left foot out. Open those hips out to a side plank on that left side. Extend that right arm all the way over, deep breath in. would like to, challenging your core a little bit more. Kick through the heel and try to lift that heel up in line with the hips. If you guys would like to go into a twist here, begin to bend your right knee, curling that foot close to your hips, reaching back with the right hand, grab a hold of it, and beginning to kick your foot into your hand, opening the chest, opening the hips, as you glide those shoulders together, breathe, focusing on your inhales and exhales out through the nose. Exhale and release. Allow the right hand to come back down to the floor. Switching to the opposite side. Right hand comes down, left or right knee kicks out. Left foot extends back as you open up the arms, stacking the shoulders. Begin to extend that left arm all the way up and over. Begin to lift that left leg here if you guys would like to. Lining that heel as you kick through your heel. Lining it with your hips. Slide the shoulder blades back. Open the chest, but pull that rib cage down. Allow yourself to go into that twist by pulling that left foot into your hips. Opening up, begin to kick your foot into your hand as you open up your shoulders. Differences between that left and that right side. Exhale, release all the way back till we get to our tabletop. We're going to move into the lizard. So you're going to step your right foot all the way to the outside of that right hand. Allow your chest to lift so we have this nice long torso. And if you feel open, you could come down to your elbows. You can keep your knee relaxed. Or to make it a little bit more intense, you can always curl your back toes under and lift your back knee up off the ground. So wherever you are, control your breathing, control your movement, not letting yourself get to a point of pain or overstretching. Nice, gentle stretch. If you're onto your forearms, come up onto your hands, and we're going to move into your corkscrew. So the right knee is going to open out to the side, and we're going for another twist here. So if you want to stop here, that's okay. But if you're ready to go into that next twist, you're going to push through that shoulder, reach that right arm up, and your back foot curls in order for you to reach back and grab a hold of your foot. Keep that right knee reaching out to the side so you can see the bottom of your right foot. Stay active through your shoulders so you're not just sinking down, but you're pressing. Gently release. Come all the way back down to the mat. Take the right leg back behind you and come back to tabletop. We're going to switch the other side. So that left leg is going to swing to the front. Great. Stretch the right leg back here if you guys need to. And again, always find that length first and then begin to lower yourself down to the floor here if you're able to come onto your forearms. You can always lift your back knee up to intensify that movement or challenge yourself a little bit more strength-wise. Take another big breath here. We're going to transition into that corkscrew. So if you're onto your forearms, come all the way up onto your hands. Left toes are going to turn out slightly. You can either release that hip out to the side, opening through those hips as you push through the right arm, and then from there, curling the hips under, reach back, grab a hold of your foot, and going for that quad stretch on this side. Release your foot back down to the floor. Bring your left hand onto the ground and go ahead slowly bring that left leg back. Coming back to your tabletop position. All right, we're gonna go into your pigeon pose. So curl your toes under, deep breath in, lift those hips all the way up. Take a deep breath in as you extend the right leg and go ahead and slide the right knee onto your right wrist. Stepping that left leg back. Start to release completely as we come down to the floor. Start to slowly come back up. As you extend yourself all the way back up to this high position, curl your back toes under and begin to push all the way up and back to your downward dog. Pedal out through your feet, driving one heel down at a time, nice and controlled. Extending those arms nice and straight. Exhale, drop your knees down to the ground, cross the legs, and begin to bring your hips onto the floor, bringing the soles of the feet together. Start to pull your hips close to your feet as you grab the underneath side, sitting up nice and tall. Breathe in, and as we exhale, begin to pull yourself. Your chest comes closer towards those feet. Elbows begin to press towards the inside of the thighs. and you extend through the top of the head. Finding your length as you guys extend through the top of the head, extend from those hips, and as you're exhaling, you're just trying to work your way a little bit closer, belly closer to the heels, feeling this inner thigh stretch. As you start to come out of it, nice and smooth. Coming up nice and tall. Ooh. Find your tall position. And from there, just begin to just curl forward. So trying to reach your forehead down towards your feet as we create this curl position for the spine. Draw your belly button into the spine. As you move a little bit closer, start to roll up one vertebrae at a time. Bring your hands to the outside. Start to pull those knees back up to the top. We're going to go bringing that left leg underneath, cow smile. Right leg is going to cross over top. And you're just gonna get your knees as close to stacked on each other as you can. Once your legs are in this position, sit up nice and tall. And as we exhale, you guys are gonna extend. Left arm is going to lift up, right arm is going to come out to the side. And you're gonna drive this left hip down as you extend through your left arm. Keep stretching up through the chest. Exhale, come all the way back up to the top. Begin to bow over those legs. So as we begin to fold forward, tuck the chin to the chest, round your forehead down towards the floor. Those feet flexed as you keep folding down, extending the arms at the end, nice big stretch from the sides. Relax your jaw, relax your face, and take an easy breath in, and a deep exhale out. We're going to slowly start to come out of this, so working out of that compression as we come all the way back up, nice and controlled. Go ahead and take those hands behind you. Unravel the legs and start to drop those knees from side to side. Keep the fingertips facing towards your hips. You guys get this nice forearm stretch as well through the wrist. We're gonna switch to the opposite side. So on this one, you guys are going to reach that right leg underneath. Left leg is gonna come under on top. Finding that position as you stack the shoulders. Take a deep breath in. And as we exhale, extend that right arm all the way up and over, stretching to the left. Feel that low back as you press your hips down into the ground. Keeping that heart open so we're not just collapsing forward. Start to come up slowly as we exhale. Take a big breath in as you flex your feet. And as we exhale, gently starting to lead through the chest as you bow forward, arms extending all the way out in front, being gentle per side. some deep breaths. So you sink your chest closer to the thighs, allowing the arms to extend all the way out to the front, and steady your breath. Relax your face, relax your jaw. Just ease into your position. Start to walk yourself back up. We go to those windshield wipers. So as we turn the hands to face towards those hips, unravel the feet. Start to drop those knees from side to side. Nice and slow. Coming down to the floor, we start to work our way all the way down. So in that position, grab the back of the legs. Start to roll down one vertebrae at a time, all the way down to the floor. Extend the legs, extend the arms, big stretch out. Exhale, pull that right knee into your chest. Interlace your fingers around the shin and give it a good hug. Going for our supine twist. After this hug, we take the left hand to the outside, gently pulling it across the body as you extend the right arm all the way out to the side. Finding that twist from the torso, but our shoulders stay down onto the floor. Turn your gaze to face towards your right hand. As you start to unravel back up to the top, give it a good hug, right knee to chest. Exhale, release the right leg, extend the right leg long. Inhale, pull that left shin in towards your body, interlacing the fingers around the shin. Big, tight hug. Right hand comes to the outside. Exhale, pull the right knee across the body, letting the hips rotate with the chest faces up to the ceiling. Gaze goes to your left hand as we bring out the spine, bring out the gum. Back up to the top, interlace that fingers around there, nice big height, tight hug, and then extend the right leg up to meet it as well. So from this position, going into happy baby, so extending the legs up, grab the outsides of the feet, and start to pull the thighs down. Relax your shoulders onto the mat, and start to drive the thighs towards the outside of the body. Feet are flexed up towards the ceiling, as we hold on tightly to the bottoms of those feet. Feel free to create a little bit of rock here from side to side. Okay. Release both knees, hug both knees in towards your chest. Taking a deep breath in. Fill your belly up. Feel your belly touch the thighs as you expand. Exhale. Release your arms. Release your legs. Control those feet all the way down to the floor. Place one hand onto your belly, one hand onto your heart. As you tuck the chin and pull the shoulders underneath. Closing your eyes. Acknowledging your breath. Acknowledging the power sourcing through your body. The energy you've brought. Hold. hold on to that feeling. Hold on to that power. To become a little bit more aware of your breath. Start to wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. Start to wake your body in any way that you desire or feel a need to. Thank you guys for joining. Namaste. It's like a Christmas card.